Hello and welcome to SWN Live. This is a special edition, special podcast where I'll be looking at the awards categories for the SWN podcast. SWN Year End Awards. I'm just going to get them the categories in front of me. I'm on borrowed time at the moment. For those that aren't aware, I do have a child and he's sleeping. So if he wakes up, then the stream's over. That's pretty much that's it. So we're just going to have to do what we can until then. I'm just going to get the award categories up. I'm not very organized because I've spent the last hour trying to put my son to sleep. So I could have told him a story. That would have done it. If you told him any of my articles that I've written, that would have done it as well. So thank you for joining me. For those that are unaware, those that are joining me for the first time, my name is Billy. I've just dropped stuff. My name is Billy Strachan. I own and run the SWN podcast, SWN site, everything, swnscotland.com. It is mine. So is the Twitter, Instagram. I'm the only person you'll deal with through that, really. I'm the only one that has access to them, so that'll be why. Thank you for joining me. For those that are joining me through Facebook Live, I'm just going to go and pop the link over onto Twitter just now and see if we can get any more folk through. And then we're going to just get on and have a look at the categories. And I can go through who's won previous years. I can go through my thoughts, who I think may be able to win this year, who I think would have a good shot anyway. And hopefully I can get some suggestions from you guys. We can discuss that as we go back and forth. So I'm just going to go onto Twitter now. So it's twitter.com/ScottResNet. Just to put live on Facebook. So we're trying something out. So I'm using the Zoom application and streaming it onto Facebook. I was planning to do it because hi Lewis, thanks for joining us. Hi Suzanne. I can't remember if I said I was gonna do it again, but I've done it again. Hello Suzanne. I don't know so I've planned to do this through YouTube, because that's what the folk on the Twitter said would be a good idea. It'd be a good idea to do it through Facebook, through YouTube. But I can't seem to figure out how to work that. I said didn't have permission. And at this point, like I say, borrowed time. I'm just wanted to get on and get speaking to you guys and let's look at the year-end awards. So we're through Facebook again, and I'm testing it through using Zoom and seeing how it goes. Hi, Callum. Hi, Kirsten. Hello everyone for joining us. Thank you for joining us. Hopefully I'll catch all your comments as we go through. Because we're trialing the old Zoom thing as we go here. And just hoping for the best. So if I miss your comments, I apologize profusely. But I will do my best to try and catch them and get your comments onto the show. Right, okay. So I think that's enough of us there. Let's start looking at SWN Year End Awards. So we've been doing this for 8 years now. This is the 8th annual SWN podcast. SWN, I keep saying podcast, I'm so sorry. This is the 8th annual SWN Year End Awards. We've run it every year since 2015. And we put out a big voting sheet. People can write in your votes, and that's it. I tally them up, get a percentage, and then I choose the winner. So that's pretty much what we're doing again. For the 8th year in a row, we've tried it through different. I think we started it on through like SurveyMonkey, and now we're using Google Forms, which seems to be pretty good. It's quite easy to manage and quite easy to use, and give me a good accurate percentage at the end. Of course, people have different spellings of things, which makes things a little bit more complicated. But we find a way, and I spend a good couple of days just kind of compiling lists and doing my own percentages, so it's as accurate as possible. So your vote has counted as much as it could possibly can be. Of course, we've got years where there's some strange options. There's some ones you wouldn't think would be put in there. And, you know, some years I have to take out some just like void picks. We're trying to put as much instructions as we can onto the votes, things for like match of the month and show of the month and move of the month. We tried to put like a little bit of an instruction on there, just giving me a heads up, a hand, to to actually figure out how to who you're voting for as well. So it goes out on the 1st of January every year. So that'll be no change. It'll go out 1 minute past midnight on the 31st of December, to be pedantic about it. So on the 31st of December, the form will go on the website 1 minute past midnight, and that's the voting open. The voting usually, I think it usually runs 14 days. I think it's, I've run it for 14 days in the past. I've double checked. I can't remember it off the top of my head. I think it's for 14 days it runs for. And then once the 14 days are up, I close the polling, I close the survey, and then I do a tally up. Last year, I was able to actually do a podcast about it. That's, again, that's the plan this year as well. But previously, we've just done a written article, and we've just done that as well. So that's again, that's the plan this year. It's just not, we're not deviating from the script too much. Thank you, Cameron, for joining us. Pro 2 is the go-to. I wouldn't expect anything else for you to say there, for you, Kid Thompson. So we've got loads of categories. Like I said, we're going to go through who's won the previous years as much as I possibly can, because of course some names that I will bring up on this show, on this podcast, of course, are not part of the wrestling world in general, or aren't wrestling anymore for whatever reason. So just to warn you, there will be some names that'll pop up that you're like, oh, don't mention them. We'll just move past it. We'll mention it. We'll move past it. That's just how we're going to do it. That's the best and easiest way that we're going to do it, for the sake of clarity and the sake of me putting out the information. But in the meantime, yeah, we've got loads of great content coming up on the SWN website from between now and, I'll put it out forever, but I've got 40 articles scheduled for the SWN 100, which we just started revealing this week. We revealed number 10 yesterday, which is Theo Doris, and then we revealed number 9 today, and that was Lucha DS. So every day up until Christmas Eve, we'll reveal number 1, and then on Christmas Day, we'll reveal the whole SWN 100. So that'll be the whole list. It is a very mathematical equation I had to use. Calculation, I haven't kind of revealed too much about the calculation, but I've kind of put what on the SWN 100 post, I've put like what was considered in that calculation. So there'll be some surprises. There'll be some wrestlers that will look at it and go, well, I should be on there. I should be above them. But at the end of the day, it's our first go at it, and it's a bit of fun. So just relax. It's based on the same kind of principle as PWI 500. So don't worry about it. It's just it's a bit of fun, a bit of a win loss, all that kind of stuff. Callum, Bruce putting in number 1 Aspen. I won't reveal too much. He's on there, but I won't reveal what number he is on the list there. But I haven't revealed anyone's number other than the number 10, number 9 that I have so far to anyone. But I have kind of given some wrestlers a heads up, going, just keep an eye on the list, and I think you'll be quite happy with it, or you'll be surprised, or just keep an eye on it. But yeah, it was a lot of fun to calculate. It took me ages because I decided how to do the calculation in November. So that means I had 1st of December 2021 to 30th of November 2022 of results to sift through, to get my calculations in order, to try and get everything like worked out and that. So it wasn't the best idea for me. Security Pro Wrestling, so it's like a win-lose thing. It's supposed to be legit and not who's actual best, for example. Exactly, yeah. It's the PWI 500. So win-loss record, titles win, titles retained, promotions worked for. It was the fairest way I could consider doing it, was trying to do it like the PWI. Because if I did it myself and was doing it like who's the better wrestler, then it's all subjective. So it's really just that was the fairest way that I could do it, and I thought would be the most fun way and wouldn't like explode my brain doing it. Lexi Kimbo, hey, thank you very much for joining us, Lexi. I'm hearing you had a good year. You've had a really good year. I've seen results pop up and your promos and what have you. So it's cool that you've joined us in the chat here. So hopefully Mark McAllister got number 100, even with his losing streak. just keep an eye on the bars. Keep an eye on SW1 100. I will say though, there was 365 wrestlers that we, from the promotions we feature, that were eligible, that wrestled in Scotland in 2022. That was one of the results I could get, because pretty much I got all, just about all the results I could get this year, except W3L. They're just an absolute nightmare to get it. But I would, yeah, there was so many. I think 185 were qualifiers, as in they had five matches this year in our future promotions. So if he's not 100, then he's number 101 in our hearts. So we'll go with that. But you know, keep an eye out for it. Like I say, it might be one and done. I might not do it again next year if there's a lot of backlash and arseholeness about it. But have fun, have faith. It's gonna be cool. It's interesting anyway. Especially when you see like some of the results. Trust me, it's a very interesting read. I was very surprised when I put it together. Year end awards. Let's do some of the categories here, and we can get some opinions hopefully. So we do. It's not the most elaborate of awards categories. We do Wrestler of the Year, Tag Team of the Year, International Talent of the Year, Move, Match, Feud, Show, Promotion, and a bunch of one to watches. So in previous years, Wrestler of the Year, I think it's. I don't know if this is. We do male and female categories. I'm still on the fence whether I'm just going to merge this. I discussed it with Sarah from Eat Sleep Suplex Retweet last year, and we were kind of in the discussion whether possibly we should just merge this and just do it as a Wrestler of the Year. And it's still in debate in my head. I'm still thinking maybe we should just do it. And I think next year will be the year that I'll just go, no, it's just a Wrestler of the Year. I was still putting my boy to bed at that point. But an hour and a half ago, I watched Erison Jane against Taylor Bryden from Fair City Wrestling. An amazing match, incredible match. And it wasn't an intergender match. It wasn't like, she's a girl and he's a guy. It was just an excellent match. And that's why I'm on the fence about it, because I know that there's still people out there that are differentiate between the two. So yeah, I think we're going to give it one more year of having separate awards, and then next year we're merging it into one Wrestler of the Year award. Cameron, no, the results, the votes haven't went out yet. So this is just the preview. This is me discussing the categories and hopefully getting some feedback from you guys, maybe some early picks, early favourites. The voting will start 1 minute past midnight on the 31st of December. You got 14 days. It could be seven. I will find out. 7 to 14 days, and then we'll reveal all. So yeah, Colin's in combined the award. Yep. Next year, 2023, it'll just be Wrestler of the Year. As will the one to watch will be merged as well. We'll just kind of streamline some of the categories that we've got. But as opposed to Wrestler of the Year male, we've had some amazing wins in that. So since 2015 we started this award. All these awards, pretty much all of them. So 2015 was won by Damien O'Connor, so Big Damo himself. And then we had like some Stevie Boy Xavier, we've had DCT, we've had last year's winner Andy Wilde. So it's been big names in terms of Scottish wrestling that have won this award, that have went on to win this. And it goes to show how much they've been supported during the year. And it just goes to show that it kind of is pretty good. It's giving you a gauge of what wrestlers are really hitting people's like either heartstrings or catching their eye. Because like Andy Wilde, of course, I go by Andy Roberts. He had a fantastic year in 2021. And it just the back end of it, of course, he did great work with FPWA as well, which he continues to do in 2022. So it's a case of he could win it again this year, because of his work through FPWA and his reign as UEWA European Heavyweight Champion, and he's had a great run in ICW as well. We've got Caleb. Caleb, I think Caleb was doing some scrolling of doom when he saw your face. Thank you very much. I it's like must be looking into a glasses wearing mirror right now, Caleb, because you've got a lovely chrome dome, which, you know, it's fashion. It's fashion now. Suzanne will always be Andy Wilde to me. I mean, that's just, yeah. I'm sure, I like to think he'll be Andy Wilde a little bit in our hearts. But of course, with Andy Roberts moving forward, we'll see where his year takes him in 2023. Picks for me, like, for me, of course, I would be really biased to say Aspen Faith because, of course, one of my favorites. But for Wrestler of the Year, there's so many that would just go, right, this guy has done so well, who has had an amazing year. And, of course, I have a Northeast bias because that's just where I see the primary, my live wrestling, that's where I see it. But it'd be hard to look past a guy like Zach Dynamite. Zach Dynamite would be a guy that'd be like 2022. He's just had an incredible year. He's won the Wrestle Undisputed Championship in an amazing triple threat main event. He then defended it. He then went to Fair City. He then popped up in Discovery. He's had just an amazing year all round, and he's had great opponents and great matches to go with it. From like showcase matches at FCW with Caleb Ryden and Tom Atlas, which was a great match. I was able to see it. To his work at WrestleZone, it has just been unmatched. There's been very few that have been up there at his caliber this year for as a wrestler. So he would be probably my personal pick for 2022, even though I hate him. Even though during those hours of 6:30 to 10:00, I hate the man. He has had an incredible year as a wrestler. I've got Cameron in the chat saying Logan Smith having a great year as well. Absolutely. He won the Joker's title at Pro 2. He's having a great run in ICW. He's popping up as the young team in a lot of places. So absolutely. Logan Smith is definitely a good shout as well. I'll get you to your one to watch and when we'll eventually get to that category. Lex Gimbo saying, being biased, but Jason Reed is okay. But, I mean, it's your vote, so you can be as biased as you want. It's just more of a case of the majority, what they vote. Kilo Valhalla is now leaving the chat. Bye-bye, brother. Louise Westay with Kez Evans as a shout. Yeah, absolutely. He had the ICW reign. It ended at Fear and Loathing after, I think, literally a year reign. I was going through who he's defeated. Who's defended the title against. The list is pretty stellar. Wolfgang, Kez Evans, BT Gunn. There's Mark Haskins, I think, as well. So he's had a really great year, and he was in the PWI, the actual PWI. So, absolutely, a fantastic shout. So we'll move on. We don't want to get too many suggestions in there, because they'll be here all night otherwise. So we've got Wrestler of the Year female. So, like I said, next year we're going to merge this, the 2023 awards. We'll see this just as a one award, Wrestler of the Year. But the names that have won this in the past, incredible. 2015 started with Nikki Storm, of course, now Nikki Cross. And then we've had Doudrop, of course, Viper. Alba Fire, Kaylee Ray, she won it in 2019. Then we've had Emerson Jane, won it in 2017. Doudrop being the only two-time winner of this award. It's still weird calling her Doudrop after all this time. Emily Hayden winning it in 2020, and then Angel Hayes winning it last year, which was well deserved on there. For me, I was trying to think who would be who's had just an incredible year in Scotland. Of course, we've seen the likes of Emerson Jane do amazing stuff in England and in Ireland and going over to Israel and what have you. So, of course, you'll always be a contender because you've done great stuff in Discovery and Fair City. But it's Molly Spartan, isn't it? It's Molly Spartan this year, surely. Casey, maybe? Casey as well, one of the She-Wolves, possibly. Angel Hayes had a good year as well. I think it'd be hard-pressed to deny Molly Spartan the accolade this year, but again, I will put my vote in as everyone else will, and we'll see what everyone says. Suzanne saying Molly Spartan. Yep, absolutely. Caleb saying Molly Spartan as well. Yeah, I don't think it'll be a landslide. I think it'll be close. I think some folk will go for Casey. Some will still go Angel Hayes as well. Ashley Vegas had a good year. It's been a very good year for wrestling in general. Debbie Dahmer as well. She's had an excellent year at Fair City. And of course, she's making appearances at Discovery as part of the Double Ds. Daisy Jenkins. Love Daisy Jenkins. Great shout there, Alexei. I think she might be a bit more of a contender for the one to watch, possibly. Louise throwing in Joe Henry for the male wrestler of the year. Yeah, he's had a great year. As far as Scotland goes, he's only had like three matches or something like that. It's all been Discovery. So maybe not so much. I mean, if he wins it, he wins it. But maybe it's not so much this year kind of thing, because he's done so much work outside of Scotland. But again, I'm just going to put the form out there and just see what happens. Tag team of the year we've got coming up as well. The last few years, it's been dominated by Polo Promotions and Kings of Catch. Polo Promotions won it in 2015, and they had two. 2015 and 2016, and then Kings of Catch won it back-to-back 2017 to 2019. 2020 saw Krieger, Luke King Sharp, Glasgow Grindhouse win, and then last year was the 9-9 for 2021. So that's great bunch of tag teams. I think Caleb's kind of said it for me, tag foundation of the future. There's been a good team this year. Thatcher's Cabinet was a pretty good year as well. Of course, Glasgow Grindhouse had a great year. Kings of the North as well. They've done enough work in Scotland. I think they'd be more than qualified to go into the pot for that. So Woke Academy, yeah, they've had a great year. KOE as well, of course, when SW Tag Team Championships. I think they're still SWA Tag Team Champions as well. Manifesto, the Young Team, Mr. P and Shaw Johnson, the Outfit. There's a lot of good choices for tag team this year. I think the last few years it's been a bit of a case of like maybe like three or four She-Wolves. They could easily go in there as well. There could be very much outside shouts like Session Money. I think it was Session Money they were called. Session Moth Martina and Gene Money. You never know, they could be in there. The Double Ds, the 9-9 could still be in there. So yeah, we've had a great year for tag team wrestling. It's been excellent. Cameron Finlay, it's Cameron putting in Arcade Violence again. I think they might be your one to watch kind of category, possibly. They had a pretty good back end of the year through Iron Girders, and they just made an ICW debut, and they're coming up to debut in Pro 2 soon as well. Lewis Young with Woke Academy, yeah, absolutely. They've been popping up in a lot of places, and of course they had an ICW Tag Team Championship match. Jem, welcome to the chat. Hopefully you'll throw in some 2 pence, of course. We'll have the one to watch to discuss soon as well. Suzanne saying the Double Ds would be hilarious. Yep, Double Ds. Fair City Saints. We have Fair City Saints. Casino Brutal. Skinner and Vice. It's just, yeah, tag team wrestling has been great. Thank you for throwing, because I can't, like, I actually forgot about Casino Brutal for a moment. I'm like, yeah, they did great in Iron Girders this year. So, absolutely. Tag team year is well open for business. Who knows who could win that? So we'll just move on to International Talent of the Year, formerly known as Import of the Year. It was won by Mick Foley initially in 2015. Of course, he did two shows that year. He did WrestleZone Christmas Chaos Comes Early, and then he did ICW Fear Loathing the same year. So previous winners, it's been quite an eclectic mix. We've got Mick Foley, we've got Kurt Angle, Matt Riddle in 2017, Sugar Dunkerton in 2018, MVP in 2019, and 2021 was Big Demo. First Big Demo winning Wrestler of the Year back in 2015, and then winning International Talent of the Year in 2021. Suzanne, you've nailed it there. Scotty Too High. I'd probably put Scotty Too High quite high in that. When you think of talent, but it's one of those weird things. It's what people think is an international talent. Scotty Too High would probably be my pick for it, but folk might think, say, Martina, they could class her as international talent. Could be her. Louise Weston, you say, Mark Haskins, Bon Vertigo, these guys could be class as international talent. So it's really down to Nitro Green, the guys from Copenhagen Championship Wrestling, could be them. So this is why it's very open to interpretation. As long as they've had a match at least in Scotland this year, that's kind of my only remit for that. But again, it's just down to the majority. If a lot of people vote for Mark Haskins and he wins, then he's our international talent of the year. That's just the way it goes. So again, so open to interpretation for what is classed as international talent. Seen Gaia Hawks come over through Copenhagen, and he through Copenhagen Championship Wrestling, and he wrestled at W3L. He had an incredible match with Taylor Bryden. So he could be a contender. Sebastian Day, the Seb Silvers, these guys that have wrestled this year in Scotland. It's such a so wide open. Buffa, how could I forget Buffa? Thank you, Suzanne. But Buffa, he had a good tour in the UK and Scotland as well. I wrestled places like W3L and Copenhagen and what have you. So yeah, it's again very open who could win this award. And Buffa's a great shout. I would like I say I would probably go for Scotty. That'd be my personal opinion. Of course, things can change because this will run. Who knows who Johnny Storm? He's 10. He could technically be an international talent. He's got a couple of matches at WTL coming up at the end of the year. So yeah, it's very interesting, a very open, wide open space for open to interpretation. Like I say, move of the year. So this was a fairly new award. It came in 2018. That's when we started the move of the year one with Afterburner, King's Catch. 2019 was Shadowfax from Emerson Jane. And last year was Kale Valhalla's Hellride winning the award. Moves of the year. That's a difficult one. Again, open to interpretation for what you would say would be the move. I'm trying to think of one off the top of my head. It's probably... I'd probably put out there. I do enjoy Zach Dynamite's kill shot. It's pretty cool. It's one of those ones. It's trying to remember how moves are called as well. That doesn't help. Dino's roaring elbow is amazing. It's so hard, like so hard and high impact. I would probably put that up there as well. We've got Omar Muhammad's throwing some submissions now with the big Kachowski. That could be in there. We've also got so many options for that. I'm just trying to think of any more cool moves. Throw some suggestions into me. Who's got cool moves? Ian Skinner's Brainbuster. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's a good shout as well. Thank you. Suzanne, you're saving chat tonight. You're saving me from just forgetting things and then paranoid looking at beam monitor here. Alex in the chat, hello. Jem, neck breaker, who loves a good neck breaker? Can't be a good neck breaker. It's a top move. So move the beard, that's probably what I'm gonna have to have a good think on. The Darkest Lariat is pretty cool. This is Aspen Faith's one, of course, because you know, well, of course I know everything about that. Like the Chop Lariat combination is so yeah, it's I'm gonna have to maybe do a bit of research on that as well. Volver goes V trigger. Yeah, possibly. Yeah, throw that in there. This is all helping everyone else as well for some suggestions. Move of the year. A lot of good shouts there. Thank you very much. Match of the year. Now, this has been fairly dominated by ICW. Every year it's been a fear loathing match. It's won. To start in 2015 with Grado and Drew Galloway. We've had the Kings of Insanity matches win in, Jacopolo Lionheart in 2018. Kings of Insanity, Steve Boyd beat D Gun in 2021 as well at Fear and Loathing. So again, won't lie to you. Oops, cough for a second though. Thank you very much. I won't lie to you again, most of my watching this year has been in WrestleZone and I've been catching things at Fair City and just where I can elsewhere. Suzanne, suggestion Kez, Craig Anthony, Steve, James Lee to Buzzard for Fear and Loathing. Absolute contender from what I hear. I'm going to watch it on Saturday when it goes out on the WWE Network. I've heard great reactions about that show, so I really want to go and and check it out. Of course, I'll be biased. Either the triple threat matches, either at Aberdeen Anarchy or at Christmas Chaos between Aspen Faith, Damien, and Zach Dynamite. I'd throw that out there. I would also put in right at the start of the year, it was Caleb Valhalla versus Crusher Crave. That was a beautiful match of just two big lads smacking each other about. Fear Loathing 4-Way, Stressed by Westy again. Yeah, I think that's probably going to be a popular choice. I usually find, because we do year-end awards, latter half of the year, really kind of, that's where you kind of find your matches of the year, because they're fresh in memory. I've seen some great matches on Pro 2 this year. I've seen great matches from Fair City as well. Like I said, that Taylor Bryden versus Emerson J match was great as well. Suzanne coming up with Deathmatch, DBT got a clip Margera for ICW. Yeah, I think that was one of the Newcastle shows that's on the WWE network. So possibly, yeah, I'll throw that in there. Trying to think of the ones off the top of my head. But just again, we're so lucky. Caleb versus Johnny Lyons would be FPWA, I'm guessing. Oh, no, would it be FCW, wasn't it? Oh, thank you. Thank you, Suzanne. Thank you for clarifying. So it was Fair City just recently, December 10th, I think that match was. There's so many, again, so many matches this year. We're very lucky in Scotland when it comes to the quality of wrestling that we've had this year. I see a couple of great matches at Combat League as well. So I'm going to put some of them in there in my mind, trying to figure out a match. We've got Lewis Young suggestion, Andy Wild versus James Mason. Of course, that was FPWA, it was the Night of the Wrestling. And Community Pro Wrestling, both Grado with Thatcher Wright. I've heard great things. I'm really going to see some of these matches and shows, because again, I'm stuck with what I can see in my surrounding area and what I can pick up on YouTube. So I'm going to need, hopefully some of these matches will go out on YouTube or what have you, Daily Motion, Vimeo, I don't know. And I can possibly see some of these matches and have a little bit more of a wider thought on these things. Cameron putting in Logan Smith, Dean Ford for the Joker's title. So they had the ladder match coming in 2023. So they had a good feud. So yeah, that, again, throw that in there. That could be a contender for feud. Possibly throw that in there. Community, go to YouTube or hit me up. I can send you both. I will do that once this stream ends or tomorrow once I've had sleep. I will get in touch with you guys because I will watch some Community Pro Wrestling, because I love, if anyone has watched podcasts I've done and they've seen me talk to anyone who's done a Govan show, whether it's for Source or for Community Pro, I am enamored by that crowd. It is terrifying. I'm enamored by it. So that's definitely, yeah, on there. Jem, Grado, Thatcher Wright. Yeah, absolutely. Again, these are great suggestions for people that are maybe sitting there going, I can't think of one to put in there. And then you guys are helping them out as well. So feud of the year. So Cameron mentioned Logan Smith and Dean Ford. Absolutely. Again, my bias being Northeast. I would put in of course the Dynamite Aspen Damien. That's because it was a fantastic story for the year. I throw in also Captain Alan Sterling and Caleb Valhalla. I'd throw that in there as well. So there's plenty of good stuff as well. So yeah, what have you guys got there for? We'll definitely hopefully we'll cover a community show. Once I get a link, I will review a Community Pro Wrestling show as soon as possible. Once I get a look at it, I'll do that. Suzanne off to Source just this weekend. Yeah, we've got Source coming up, of course. It could be a match of the year, do their stuff there as well. Cameron advertising Pro 2 days as well. Yeah, we'll put that up on the site. So if you go to SWNScotland.com, as well as it being on YouTube, being advertised through Pro 2 Wrestling, we put them up on there as well. So feud of the year, we've got Suzanne suggested BT Gunn and Jack versus Jack Jester. Absolutely. They had their Kings of Insanity match, which I'm looking forward to seeing. Any feud involving Rosie Adler. She had a couple feuds up in Combat League this year, so absolutely. Westy with Craig Evans and Craig Anthony. I'm sorry, Kez Evans and Craig Anthony. Yeah, Aspen, Faith, and Mark Haskins. Yep, that's Discovery. So possibly we'll throw that in there. Theodorus, Jack Morris. That's been happening this year as well. Well, that could be a good contender for Feud of the Year. Yeah, play good stuff. So sorry for coughing. Yeah, so plenty of good contenders for Feud of the Year as well. So I've also had like Looking Sharp for Mike Musso. That was a good feud. That was quite a good bitter feud. Stuff with the Govan team and Thatcher's Cabinet down at Community Pro, that could be in there as well. Yeah. I'm going to say yeah a lot. I'm so sorry. It shows my lack of preparation for this particular episode. But yeah, there's lots of good contenders for those as well. Show of the Year, we've got on there. So a few of the year, I'd even mention the past ones we've had. We had Kez Evans, Craig Anthony last year for 2021. We've had things like a lot of names I can't say. Lionheart and Jackie Polo 2018, we had that as well. And then again, we've had things like New Age Click Legion 2015, Whiplash, Stevie Boy, Doris Saint as well in the past, Faith Gervin. So there's been plenty of ones in there. Suzanne throwing in Dickie Divers versus Debbie Dahmer. Yeah, why not? They've had this kind of love-hate relationship this year that absolutely could be a contender for Kev. It's down to the majority. I'll do my best to try and rein in some of the more outlandish options of votes. But again, my thought is if people vote enough, if there's enough votes in, it'll kind of weed out the silly ones. They'll stay at the bottom, and then the more legit ones will go to the top. But you know, things happen. People can take over votes. It's been proven. It's been shown in the past on previous votes that things are done that it can get a bit wild. Jackie Polo DCT for next year. Yeah, absolutely. I'll throw that in there, Suzanne. Show of the Year. So this has kind of been two promotions that have really vied for this each year. It's been either ICW, it's usually a Fear and Loathing show. They've did Fear and Loathing 8. I'm trying to work in Roman numerals here. Fear and Loathing 8 in 2015, and then one Fear and Loathing in 2016, 2018 as well. And Discovery Wrestling, I've come in 2017, 2019, 2021 with Bullet versus Bullet Club, Camp Discovery, and just goes back as well as their winning shows. Again, I'll go ahead and throw in my Northeast bias in here. Arty Anarchy this year was phenomenal. Halloween Hijinks was Halloween Hijinks was good. Christmas Chaos was a beautiful show as well, with lots of highs and lows of the emotions. Discovery have had some really good shows this year. I remember watching them online, so they could be in there. Renegade had a couple interesting shows. I don't know if they were maybe contenders to win, but they were certainly interesting to watch. Suzanne going for Fear and Loathing. But we're okay with biased here. Don't worry about biased here. It's your vote, so it's just what happens. We can all merge in there and get your opinions across. W3L Summer Spectacular was really good. I've actually got a code to watch some of their shows this year, so I'm going to try and check out things like Resolution in the coming months, and hopefully maybe do a bit of writing about them. FPWA did a couple of good shows this year. From what I'm hearing as well, I'm going to go and check, see what things have won our like shows of the month this year, because that'll help us, because we'll get some options popping out there. So we had WrestleZone Summer Hill Showdown in January, Source Resurgence in February, Fear City with March Madness in Perth, Friday Night Disco from Discovery in April, Avenue Anarchy in May, Disco Derby in June from Discovery, Discovery again with Tagged in July, WrestleZone Battle of Nations in August, FPWA Right the Wrestling, that was September, Fear City Rumble in October, and then Discovery Wrestling Year 7 in November. So there's been a couple good shows in there. Lexi Kimbo saying picking Fear and Loathing, but watch out for FPWA. Absolutely. And Suzanne saying always love the Disco Derby. So plenty of options, plenty of choices. Let's move on. See what we've got. So just done Show of the Year. Promotion of the Year. Again, this has just been back and forth most years. ICW win in the first one in 2015, and they also win it in 2016 and 2020, 2017, 18, 19, and in 2021. It was Discovery Wrestling that won it. So again, I would always go wrestle. That's just my opinion, because I've went to so many shows this year. But of course, Discovery is going to have a good hold on a lot of people, because they always put on top quality shows as well. Lewis Young said FPWA, absolutely, they put on two great shows at Truth, and they've had a good year with bringing in talent, bringing in matches and stuff like that. Paranoid for a second because Jack has moved. So that could be, FPWA could be a dark horse there. Fair City could be a good shout there. Pro 2 could be a good shout. Community Pro, it just really depends on who's voted, really. So if the guys from if folk that go to Fair City pop up and go in their masses, they could win it easily. Community Pro saying one company sold out every show they ran in Scotland this year. Wrestle, we're not far behind. I think possibly the only didn't sell it was maybe Nations Split. I can't remember. They did pretty well. So Community Pro, absolutely, they could be a good contender as well. So I think it's trying to beat past the two like giants in Scotland, which is ICW and Discovery. If someone's able to break through that, then you're on to a winner for promotion of the year. Right, we're on to the one to watches now. Again, we're gonna merge this next year. The one to watch male, one to watch female. We're gonna merge them into just one to watch wrestler into next year. But this year, we're still gonna separate them. So we'll start with male. One to watch male. We've had Aspen Faith win it in the past, 2015, 2016. We've had Zach Dynamite in 2017. We've had Spike Tierney 2018. Ryan Riley 2019. 2020 was Leighton Buzzard, which is a pretty good one. 2021 was Ian Skinner, who had a fantastic 2022, who should be, I could possibly put him as a contender for Wrestler of the Year as well. One to watch, though, for male wrestler. Tommy Cartel, he's doing pretty well. Ryan Richards as well, he's had a pretty good time with it. A lot of the guys from FPWA. Tom Atlas, Suzanne, excellent choice. Tom, a big fan of Tom here. We've got Colton Davis. Maybe he'll have probably a good standout year as well. Judas Gray, guys like Ronan King, Reese Dawkins as well up here. He's had a very good year. So we're very spoilt. Again, we're very spoilt for choice when it comes to one to watch. So who's going to have a great year? Westy put it in. Just pick up the dudes ones just now. Frank Gallows, Shaman A. Ian Skinner, Levi, Brent Carter, great choices. Suzanne Duke Cannon, got Alex with Dan J. Blair, Cole Davis, Kyle Bruce with Ronan King, Reese Dawkins, and Tom Atlas. I'd throw in Omar Muhammad in there as well. Lexi, Robbie Balfour, Ross Hunter, Suzanne Echo with Dan J. Blair. Yeah, absolutely. These are all great, fantastic choices. In there. So as far as female goes, tough one. I mentioned Daisy Jenkins earlier. I think Daisy Jenkins would be an absolute shout for it. Nicole Jasmine as well. I've comments have started disappearing, so I've tried to see them. Lexi Kimball with Tom Atlas. Lexi could throw in, could be in these categories as well. Again, I'm trying to get else. Daisy Jenkins definitely in there as a. I would even say Ashley Vega possibly as an outside bet. She did win it in 2018, 2019, but what wild possibility that she could be one to watch for 2023. Same as Brody Adler won it last year. Emily Hayden won it in 2020. Emerson Jane won it 2015, 2016, 2017 as well. So it's again very open on who could win these, but. Yeah, we're spoilt for choice. Ellie Armstrong. Ellie Armstrong could be in there as well. Ellie, who possibly had my favorite article up on the SWN site this year, which was her 10 vegan meat alternative picks, which got picked up by Simon Howie, I think it was, as well. I don't know if she got any free merch. I hope she got some free vegan square sausage. John Young thrown in Taylor Bryden as, I don't know, one to watch, wrestler of the year, possibly both, either. He's probably well suited for either. Wesley Martin McAllister as well. Hopefully he'll get a win. Fingers crossed he'll get a win, a singles win this year, into 2023, I should say. But yeah, possibly he is the one to watch, as well. On to watch tag team. So we mentioned earlier, there's so many tag teams right now. I almost ate my mic there. We've got so many tag teams in Scotland right now that we're just spoiled, really. We've got the Woke Academy. They could be pretty contenders. The past winners of this award have been Kings of Catch 2017, KOE 2018, Foundation of the Future in 2019, KOE again in 2020. 2021 was Thatcher's Cabinet as well. So one to watch tag team. Again, you could say KOE, even though they kind of, I say they're a bit more established now. But yeah, Woke Academy. Sorry, one to watch male, of course. Cameron Finlay said Mayhem Brooks. So yeah, Mayhem Brooks absolutely could be a contender for that as well. He had a great match with Craig Stevens and W3L up here recently at the start of December. So absolutely, he's kind of really started to evolve a bit more and have a bit more of a character about him, so that should be good. Once he's asked to Botchko, who knows. Spike Tierney, first pass winner as well. Lex Gimbo, Woke Academy, yep, absolutely. Suzanne Rust, the young team, could be in there also. There's plenty of good ones. One to watch again. Yeah, it's really just down to who you think is going to have a good 2023. Maybe a team that will break out and have just a really good year, and they'll just burst onto the scene. You could throw in Fair City Saints there. Sure, they won the Wrestling Tag Team Championships at Christmas Chaos, but you know, they could break out a bit more as well into 2023. So Fair City Saints as well would be a good shout. We're piling through this. How long have I been on for? Just about 50 minutes. Okay, cool. About 45 actually, once I take out the first initial silence of me getting confused about this live streaming. So yeah, plenty of good, great choices coming in. Redgate as well from Fair City. Yeah, terrifying tag team. Actually, Fair City have got a really great tag team division forming. They've got their tag team titles being determined next year. They've got teams like the Foundation of the Future, Fair City Saints, they've got Botchko, Spike Tierney, Redgate, Glory Hunter Enterprises as well. So they've really started to bring in tag teams in Perth and Fair City and Dundee as well, which is very interesting to watch. They've really kind of started to lock down their divisions really well, between their heavyweight division, their junior heavyweight division, and their tag division, and their women's division especially. They're bringing in really great talent into Fair City for their women's division. So keep an eye on them for your tag team stuff next year as well. But one to watch tag team the Outfit, you can throw that in there as well. Suzanne's suggestion, Caleb and Johnny Lyons team for the FCW tag belt. Yes, please. Yes, I don't know what to call the team. Something about Vikings and Lions, but I am all over that. Thank you very much. Yes, please. So yeah, plenty of choices on there. So I'm hoping, but by listening to this, you're really getting some ideas for yourself going, oh, maybe that team. Oh, I hadn't thought about that team. Maybe that team. We could get something together and you could throw out there. One to watch promotion is the penultimate award that we've got going on here. So previous years, 2016 was Reckless Intent. WrestleZone won it in 2017, 2019. Source 2018, Fierce Females in 2020. And Fair City won it last year in 2021. So Wesley getting back to the tag team, Andy Roberts and Jason Reed's team. Yeah, absolutely. One to watch promotion though. Lewis Young, FPWA. Suzanne, FCW. Both solid choices. FPWA really started to burst out there with their shows. I would put Iron Girders in there as well as possible contender for one to watch as a promotion, because their shows this year had a lot of good feedback, and been able to watch a couple of them on some of the matches, and they've uploaded enough to have one or two full shows, I think, on YouTube, so we'll check them out. Wesley with FPW 8-hour girders. Yep, absolutely. Combat League, I think, would be a possible interesting choice to have in there. They've really had their first year properly and wasn't hampered by the pandemic, and they had a really cool concept of their league system. So throw that as a dark horse, maybe. Lexi Kimbo, FPWA, but honorable mention to FCW and girders. Yep. Discovery Wrestling. Sorry, I don't know how Discovery Wrestling got in there. Alex with Fair City Wrestling, strength this year. Yep. Again, like I said, they're kind of locking down their divisions pretty cool, pretty well, and they're bringing in cool and great talent to mix up from the likes of FPWA or WrestleZone. I just love their kind of hybrid promotion, which is bringing in talent from not only their own school, but also having folk from both sides of the up and down the country as well. Suzanne with Community Pro, yeah, again, they've already pointed out that they're one of the only promotions, I think, or the only promotion in Scotland this year that sold every show that they put on. So that's a pretty good contender for not only promotion of the year, but possibly for one to watch as well, to see how they go from strength to strength in 2023. Again, dark horse, we could see Copenhagen Championship Wrestling get a couple of votes in because it had a really good debut, and they're returning in 2023. Again, that would get very dark horse, but that's a possible one in there. Source under new management possibly could be in there, Clyde Valley maybe. So we're very spot for choice when it comes to wrestling in Scotland, and anyone, there's no guarantees any of these awards, which makes it the most exciting thing, coming on these podcasts and on these votes and awards and stuff like that. Suzanne saying, pretty respect pro isn't good anymore. Yeah, but it looks like they're kind of possibly pro two. So pro two is one to watch as well. Throw that in there. Respect pro is kind of there, replacing Lochwinnock is kind of getting picked up by Copenhagen if they're maybe running a bit more regular. That next year, I don't know. You'd have to ask the team at Copenhagen Championship Wrestling. So that's the final award is SWN Podcast of the Year. So this one only started in 2020, which was a pandemic vote really, because there's no shows past March that year outside of ICW and some closed door stuff. So previous winners, have seen Ian Skinner won it the first year in 2020, then Ian Ambrose won it in 2021. We've put out a lot of episodes in 2022. The Alex Brown put in Alex Webb's Christmas one. Yes, the holiday special. I've put a little TikTok out as well about it, because I've decided to try and clip some bits about me. About me asking stupid questions on the show. West Ham would wrestle Daft. Technically would be a valid vote because I didn't do an episode called that this year. But you know, got lots to try. Scully's here. Scully. Oh, goodness me. How was the jaw? I don't know what to ask a skull. Maybe we'll get you on the podcast next year for 5 minutes. So Alex would say, watch the Alex Webb one. Great, thank you, because it's like 800 views or something ridiculous this year. As far as podcast episodes that are valid, all of them are valid this year, everyone I've done. So even like things like ITV Celebrity Wrestling video, The Rise and Fall of ITV Celebrity Wrestling, that'll be valid as well, because it was a podcast. Kinda. It was more of a 30 minutes of me going, oh man, remember this? So that could be in there. I'm trying to think of other episodes. Well, I wouldn't need the list because I did so many. Not to show off or anything, but I did so many episodes for season 4 or 4.5 that I had a lot of fun with. Just gonna find it now. Scrolling. Season 4. We've had two Alex Webb episodes. We had Into the Webverse at the start of the year, then we had the holiday special at the end of it. I had Big Demo on, of course. Ashley Vega's second episode was sublime. I loved that episode so much. Of course, we had the road trip episodes this year. Tom Atlas was a really fun chat. course, had Ian Skinner back for Skinner, I hardly know her. I've got McIver back on as well. Of course, with Scotty Swift returning, as always. Brody Adler's Google's Dynamite. We had poetry on that episode. So that's one to worth watching and go back to. Of course, we had Aspen back on. We had Rory McAllister, Highlanders, as a guest, as a Bruce Lee bonus on there. Nicole Jasmine, we had her on as well. That was really good. Hi, Scully. Saw you for the first time at FCW recently. Of course, I thought that was Scully speaking to me for a second. I was terrified there going, I wasn't there. But it's fine. Suzanne's talking to Scully in our chat. That's fine. That makes sense. All makes sense now. Brody Adler, Dean Skinner, Suzanne. Yeah, absolutely. Brody's one was a blast because we've done two chats before, and this one I didn't really do a lot of prep because we've had so many chats before. I didn't really need to do as much prep. We were just kind of let it all hang loose, so to speak. And I say we delved into poetry, which that'll be in our clip that I'll put on TikTok. So I'm sorry, Brody, about that. We had some great ones with like Rob Stowe as well. And we had the Day of Birth Bonanza, which was a riot, absolute riot to do, because it broke down so quickly. Tom Atlas being threatened to go into a fridge. So it's worth watching again if you want to see it. It starts off with Ian Skinner like grilling me, and then it ends with I think at some point he walks out. So you're really gonna have to go check out the Day of Birth Bonanza, especially. Alex saying, good story, Brody loves to chat with me. Ah, well, thank you very much. I try my best. I don't know. I try the word. I just kind of just hit the button that says record and just hope for the best. Suzanne said Nicole Jasmine's episode. Yeah, that was a really fun episode because it's interesting when you have guests that don't have a lot of matches or have any matches, maybe have one or two. So you kind of have to delve into something a bit deeper with those guests. Harmony Skies was a really great episode as well. We finally did an episode on Halloween with her. I really enjoyed the one with Rally. The 4.5 ones were a bit different because there were so they were just like some returns, some few bar between, a lot of road trip episodes. So yeah, throwing in them in there as well. It's been a very good year. A very good year for the SWM podcast, if I do say so myself. I mean, technically, if you want to be technical about it, you can go through the Rewind episodes as well. We put out some Rewind ones after the birth of my son, and I wasn't recording anything. I just put out some old episodes that have been voted for by yourselves on Twitter. So we had episodes with Billy Kirkwood, Johnny Lyons, Mickey Vago go out, the Super Executioner, and Crusher Crabe. So we had those kind of episodes go out. The one with Matt Wolf was good fun as well. Daisy Jenkins has been on. She was lovely. With London Love Lust. Yeah, we've had a really good year. Really good year. Sam Barber Experience was another beautiful episode. We had Theodorus on. We had Craig Berry on as well. I've done all right this year. Brent Carter came back. That was, again, a very interesting episode because it kind of exploded everything in his life for a little bit. So that was a bit interesting. KJ Mack was on. Yeah. Go and check out some back catalogue episodes, either through Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or through YouTube. There's going to be a gem or two in there for you. And if there's a particular bit that you find absolutely hilarious, let me know. So, Suzanne saying, listen to older ones. I said a venue for a show to start earlier with ADM. Again, that was an absolute blast. That was my lasting memory is the Dean Ford conversation. That was hilarious. I don't know if I'll ever get ADM back on because he's a terrifying man. But I'm still hoping, holding out hope that we do this IT Crowd podcast and it happens and we can speak about all the IT Crowd stuff forever and ever. But yeah, fingers crossed. That's it. That's all the categories. I'm just going to try it and I've lost. There we go. Right, find them. So, yeah, that's all the categories this year. We usually have an admin award as well. And the winner of that, we usually just do, last couple of years, we've just done one, which has been our Hall of Fame kind of thing, our Outstanding Recognition Award for Extraordinary Service. I'm not sure who's going to win that this year. So in previous years, we've had Carmel Jacob win, Wolfgang, Drew Galloway, Lionheart, Johnny Lyons, and Nikki Storm. So I've got a couple ideas, perhaps, who could be in that conversation as a outside wrestler for Extraordinary Service. I don't want to reveal who I have in my head who could be. It's really just someone who's really fully represented Scottish wrestling. I've done a great job at promoting Scottish wrestling. So it's not so much of a case of they have to be retired, but it's possibly they're not so active in the actual Scottish wrestling scene now, maybe. So it is like a Hall of Fame kind of thing. But I've got a couple thoughts in mind who could be in contention for that. So keep an eye out on the SWN site at the start of the year, and I'll might have an announcement about that, but I'll leave that as a little tease for you. So that's it. That's just previewed the SWN year-end awards. Jack has been, outside of a couple wriggles, he has been quiet, which is nice. So he'll probably, as soon as I hit stop record, he will be like, ah! But hopefully I have enough time to go and wet my whistle, because I should have brought up a glass of juice or something, but I haven't, so I again apologize for the coughing. But no, thank you very much for joining us, joining me here. Thank you for joining in. Suzanne, how old is Jack now? 5 months. He's born July 16th, so he's 5 months. I know, it's time has either flown by very fastly or stood still. So I'm gonna go in and relax for a moment before everything kicks off again. But thank you very much for taking the time to chat to me tonight. It's been really nice. It's been great interaction, and we'll be able to get some ideas bouncing about. I do have some ideas for podcasts next year. I've got some guests that I have in the pipeline, some very interesting guests, some very wild guests when it comes to, you wouldn't think they would be on the SWN podcast, and I'm hoping that some of them, if not all of them, pan out. If they do, we have some fun lined up for you. And hopefully we'll do the Day of Birth Bonanza, and hopefully we'll do a movie quiz next year as well. John, thank you for all you do. William, thank you. It's an absolute pleasure. Now my life is doing this work, doing my actual job at the same desk, doing my actual job, the shoot job. Looking after my son, of course, with Kelly as well. She's taking her first ever night out since the birth of our son, and she's bloody deserved it. So I'm in charge, which is a terrifying prospect for everyone. But no, this is my haven. It's my safe space. This is so my head doesn't explode and I don't cry and break down. It's just wrestling, and that's what will continue to be. Lewis jumping in, where is your Security of the Year award? Lol. I mean, you didn't do much to stop restocking Scottie Swift with a Shakespeare book. That's all I'm saying. So I'm gonna leave it to that. I think that's the best way I can wrap up. The award starts, voting starts on 1 minute past midnight on December 31st, 2022. And you can go and check out all the stuff on swnscotland.com. We'll have stuff about SWN 100. We have podcasts. We have video content. We have lists. We have reviews. We have previews. We've got everything. We're going to try and do more next year somehow, because one of my goals is to reach 500,000 views on the site in total. So we have to do some more work and more stuff. So anyone who wants to write, give me a shout. I'm happy to get some help with some content, but we've got a lot of cool things planned. Like, we've got a new spin-off podcast planned somehow that I'm thinking of doing. I've got the name, I've got the logo. I just don't know what I'm doing from that point onwards, and just organizing it. Like I said, I've got some possible crazy guests lined up, and we'll do some fun stuff as well. So thank you for continuing to support SWN, the Scottish Wrestling Network. We'll continue to report about as much Scottish wrestling as we possibly can for your enjoyment. And we'll continue to enjoy it and absolutely bag on about it, how cool stuff is. And maybe I'll calm down about Aspen Faith, but he just won the Undisputed Wrestling Championship, so it's probably okay. You can check us out on Facebook.com, which you're doing just now if you're watching the live video, Facebook.com/ScottResNet. We're on Instagram at ScottResNet. We're on Twitter, which is where you'll find me most of the time, at ScottResNet, SWNScotland.com. We're available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, YouTube, YouTube.com/ScottishWrestlingNetwork. And I'm going to go and rest my voice. So thank you once more with feeling. See ya.